Here we are, bottom of Mills Rapids. First video of 2024. The water is at 0.32, which is the level that the race will start at. Minimum possible level. My watch begins to stop working. Okay. Okay. Bells at Amiens Road. 0.32 meters of water. This is the level, this is the lowest level that they call regular for the race. At this level, the power boaters will all be starting from the regular start place, finishing regular start place. And regular times. Anything lower than this, the low water contingency plan will be in effect, which means nothing for us paddlers. Because the low water contingency plan for paddlers is everything normal. The river level is at 0.0 meters, however, the race is cancelled for everyone, including us. But we'll still do the race. Sydney. Fun little test below Bells Rapids. See what logs have washed into the river this year. Used to be a log blocking this channel. Not anymore. Oh dear. Oh, nice rig. Nice. That's a big nickel. Alright. We're evaluating this. Electric canoe to come up the other way. So, in case you weren't aware, I am now the owner of an electric canoe. It's called the Sun Thief. The old glass is fogging up. Nice little complex section there that's quite passable. And no log blocking it anymore, like it used to. That tree at the bottom. Gotta turn. Might just be enough water for the middle, although there's a big new bank here. It wasn't here before. Think you were right. just enough. Okay, if only it didn't split into three channels, that'd be fine. Plenty of water for one channel. That tree will get the tide, people. That's all that water over there that's sucking the life out of this channel. Right side, come over here. Right side, right side, right side. Now you'll get stuck there. How fast do you think the water's moving here? I was doing 7 kph there without paddling though. Yeah. So it's about the same as my younger Tabels, but much slower. Oh, it's 6k's that, yeah. Now, left-hand side of this tree used to be the way. But then middle became, well, I mean, middle went at higher, where it's higher. And then before that, the grass on the right used to shush down a bit. No, I think it's grown up in the summer. We'll see. That's where all the water's going. There's no other way to go today. Well, we can jump it. How about that? You can try there if you like. Well, both of them are hand over hands. Done that before. Yeah, the branch just out of reach. Uh-oh. Hang on. I'm gonna pull the nose around. Use your paddle to push off the wall in front of you with your body. Just push the whole boat. Yeah, but you can force the front. Do this. With the front, yeah, like that. No, push this way, like that. No, you can't get the angle. Okay. Oh, you're going under it. You can just lift up that branch. I mean, is that a doable thing? No. I think that's a pretty big branch. I could probably lift it up for you though. Could you jump that log in front of you? Could you actually ram that log in front of you and push off that with your nose, you know? It'll go under that log, won't it? Yeah. As soon as you get the nose over that log, then you'll be... I mean, just cutting that one log would fix everything. Alright, so 0.32 is a interesting one through there then. Yeah. And a bit more crunchy crunches of powerboats and people breaking them off. Yeah. I think that'll, if you get to here in the 515, then I think it doesn't matter what what that log has for you. You would have seen much worse than that. Yeah. And 0.6 is nice. Yeah. I mean, nothing beats going at 10 km/h at a regular pace. We were doing 12 km/h, I think, day one. That's still the equestrian centre up there, isn't it? Still the horse centre up there, isn't it? Yeah. I think I can can hear them doing an event or something, I think. Talk about the Murray River being in a deep riverbed the whole time. It's pretty much the same as up here. Yeah. Well, 4 days or 40 days if you're doing the whole river. Yeah, but what rivers aren't like this though? I thought this is pretty much the norm, isn't it? Oh, you can see out of the valley every so often, you mean? Yeah, yeah. I mean, a flat river is a flat river, and I don't think you can do anything to make a flat river good, but but the river banks are on all, like, it'd be pretty hard to find a river with good scenery around it, I reckon. Exactly, yeah. You'd have to go to a bloody a mountain pass in Colorado and shoot waterfalls and things. Yeah, there's nothing else to do, is there? No, exactly. That's right, we don't need scenery on this paddle because we have stuff. Yeah. Do you reckon the Mississippi or the Missouri River might be a good one? But are the banks, you don't reckon you could see out across the plains of bloody lower states and all that? Yeah, yeah. Or maybe having a 10-foot tall boat, a really, really tall vessel that you just paddle along and big camera that's just on a giant pole that you stick up in the air. Okay, yeah, yeah, yeah. And I guess they don't flood, or they haven't flooded for hundreds of years, so they don't have huge riverbanks, do they? Yeah. Yeah, true. What is that? Something floating. I don't know. Weird little thing, hey? I haven't found any yet. I think that's a good thing. Yeah, that looks dangerous. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. This one should be okay now. This is the same one that was here last year. Well, there's one just beyond here is the old barrier that used to block the whole thing. Okay, I think we have to jump a log here. But I wanted to jump it. I still jump something. Can you take the right? I think this was the obstruction before, yeah. Sorry? Okay, I think you should go to the right side, Dad. But Dory, come here now. But I just thought this was not... Oh, they're both fine. I just thought this one was harder. I'm just all about taking alternate channels when I have the opportunity. So that I know. They're both pretty easy. And that one, I don't know, that other log, that'll be a problem at point two, yeah? Ooh. maybe there are. I think maybe the... We haven't had any floods, have we? But something's washed out these channels. It's quite deep now. I don't remember it being this deep. Expecting to scrape again a few times just up near near Nev's channel. Upper Swan, around Upper Swan there, it'll be fine now because it's all open and broken apart. Remember that tree that used to block the channel and they chainsawed it up? This one, yeah. Is this not the tree that you and Melissa got out on and pulled the 5-1 around over there? Remember that tree that you guys jumped? I jumped the log, taking a million tries, and you guys had to get out and pull the 5-1 over. Remember that log, and she took a photo while you guys were pulling over. Sort of like this one here. Yeah. Melissa Jennings, yeah. Oh, below Amiens, was it? Yeah. Oh, we're almost at the wizard tree, aren't we? Yeah, just around the corner here. Jeez, yeah, that's a... So that'll be... Well, no, 0.5, you'll just go around the side. No, this is new. This wasn't here last year. New to everybody this year. Yeah. This is the area that can easily get blocked with one or two logs. You think if that thing starts, breaks free and washes down, it'll get stuck right here. Right on this other one that's still there. The old wizard tree. Yeah, it's this one that they chainsawed up. Yeah. Oh, plenty of space today. Up here. Little obstacle. How's your hand? Boss is good. Yeah. Oh, the nose, yeah. I get that. So, playing bass music in my car with the subwoofer vibrates the nasal hairs in my nostrils, and every single time I crank the stereo in my car, I have to dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it. Every 10 seconds. Can't stop it. I reckon cut your nose hairs. I reckon something to do with nose hairs. Sorry? Feels like a spider web, like a fake spider web's coming over, yeah. Ooh, that might be our first carcass up here. Oh, this is Fiona's Folly, is it? Sounds better than defeat. Yeah, well she came out on that, didn't she? Oh, that, yeah. But this is Steve's Folly as well, isn't it? No. No, it's, no, Steve's Folly. It was where Steve got stuck under the 4 and 5. But this is what's known as the powerboat jump, the powerboat ramp. This is where I cowered in here, let the powerboat pass, but he went over there and jumped through that gap there. Yeah, that gap was not there at the time. And we were over there, weren't we? Were we? Oh, I still can't. Okay, yeah. No. Was Steve's Folly the same place where that family tipped over the Canadian? Same, yep. I don't know where they were. Maybe they were trying to get to Bell's, but I mean, a little bit between here and there. Okay, here's Steve's, isn't it? Yeah. Coming up. Got another log just there. Just hiding under the water. Right there. I think you just go straight ahead now, yeah. Yeah, exactly. There's Steve's tree. Steve's Folly. Did you have to go through there though? Did you actually have to go through there, or was that Steve's mistake? No, yeah. I just have a feeling that we didn't go underneath there and then he went down there the wrong way. Like we actually missed it by going somewhere else. You know, but I don't think that we went under the same log. I think we went somewhere else. Well, I reckon maybe that side of the river was okay. I reckon further up from Steve's, we were already on the right side. Because remember, he was behind us, and we didn't know where he was, and we paddled back up to him, and he was saying, guys, what do I do here? I'm under the water, trapped under the water, yeah. But he got out, and everything was fine. Nobody drowned yet, that we know of. Yeah, well. I'd hope the banks were still used. You'd think if it never got up that high, then the bank would slowly erode away. Yeah. That big year we had recently, it was above the banks, and you didn't need to be in the main channel. You could paddle in the fields. In fact, that's the field that you shortcut, isn't it? That we can shortcut when the level comes right up. you go the other side of that field there. Oh no, sorry, it's below Upper Swan. That's right, below Upper Swan, then you take that little shortcut, yeah. I just thought this was the field, looked familiar. Yeah, not yet. Safest bet. That's a lot of driftwood, I think. There's more space there. Although, nah, it's all good. There's that other tree that's down over here, but it's long gone. It's all good. That's another cool little obstacle, if that's the case. Now you could probably come through there with no issue. You do still have to turn around there though. Yeah, okay. A little bit technical. I think you'd make it though. No fast way through there, that's for sure. Jeez. I saw something there, didn't want to chance it. Hug the right bank here, you'll be a good little way through. Watch that log there, that branch. Shoved into it. Now, am I gonna regret this? Yeah. Okay, cool. There's no pylons there. I've hit those pylons a few times. Only if there's someone in front of you. Huh. be living there. Can't say I remember those being there. Do you remember seeing these? Yeah, but I can't remember paddling through them very often. Oh, can't remember seeing them. Nice little log there. Yeah, it was off there. That's the shortcut there. That's the high water shortcut. Remember all these different channels to choose. It was more obvious, I reckon, before. Now there's multiple ways to go everywhere. a lot more options now. Thank you. Yeah, not going over there anymore. I must go there when it's a meter next time though. See what it's like. Wonder if it's still even possible. At a meter when it starts flowing down there, I'll give it a go. Waiting for a good spot to turn, but there weren't any. Now you gotta wait for a turn in the river so that you can use the natural turn. This is what we used to say was the last tea trees, wasn't it? Yeah, true. I think there's still tea trees there, but you just go past them without touching them. Yeah, true. I think that was Governor Stirling gave it a good try, and then he got up to there and then stopped. That is hilarious. Cool. Plus there's some gear on the island there. I think it's just rubbish. Yeah. You mean around the sandbar? We could take a right in a moment, but not yet. Either. Nice little technical section there. Dunk, dunk. Yeah, here's we go right. Yeah, right here. You got it, this is the way. Any earlier right and you'd be stuck. And there might have been an earlier and then now that's blocked too, yeah. I always remember we went straight in the fanfare because we couldn't make that turn and we bottomed out because it was too shallow. Yeah, it was way before that, wasn't it? Yeah. That's where we bottomed out in the fan. That one's connected. I was just checking to see if it was or not, so I was almost ready. Not quite ready though. Aha, another nice little turn. There. Can get through there. Ah, he is good, he is good. Ah, well, a few logs. And stay right, yeah, stay right afterwards. Dude, this has got a damn wall that just broke through. Little spillway. Thank you. is clean. The river, she's an uprising, but staying in the same way. I was going to take Amazon. I'll race you. I think it'll be very educational. I have to do it at least once, and this can be the one time in the year. Okay. That is Nevilles Channel over there. This is the Amazon Passage. And once again, like last year, you're about to see why it's called the Amazon Passage. No, not because there are drug smugglers using the routes for nefarious acts, but because there are trees and vines that cover the river. And this becomes a lot narrower than it is right now. With hopefully less logs than last year. Because last year, it was blocked like this. It is blocked. Keep hold of your paddle. Success! Say at least the bank is good. Oh wait. Yee-hoo. Amiens Road.